Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 9, Properties of Gaseous Mixer. So we will be discussing the properties of gaseous mixer in this lecture. We recap from the previous lectures. Earlier lecture, we discussed the properties of ideal and real gases, the various equations and the properties of ideal real gases we have discussed earlier. And in this lecture, so we'll be discussing mole fraction, mass fraction, Dalton's law of partial pressure and Amagat's law of partial volume, properties of gaseous mixer, molar mass, gas constant, density, change in internal energy, change in enthalpy, change in entropy of gaseous mixture, and the Gibbs function. And at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to state Dalton's law of partial pressure and write the equations for properties of gaseous mixture. So in the properties of gaseous mixture, first we discuss about the mass concentration or density of gas A in the mixer. The mass concentration rho A of a gas A is defined as the mass of the gas A per unit volume of the gaseous mixer. So you have a mixer of gases, of different gases. The total volume is V and the mass of the gas A is MA. So the mass concentration of that particular gas rho A equal to MA by V. And molar concentration, the molar concentration of the gas A is defined as the number of moles of gas A per unit volume of the gaseous mixture. So CA equal to NA by total volume. Number of moles of the gas, NA is the number of moles of the gas, and the capital MA is the molecular weight of the gas A. So NA by V or rho A by MA. So rho A is the mass concentration of the gas A divided by the molecular weight of the gas A. And mass fraction of the gas A is defined as the ratio of mass concentration of the gas A to the total mass density of the gaseous mixture. So mass fraction MA equal to rho A by rho. And mole fraction is defined as the ratio of number of moles of the gas A to the total number of moles of the gaseous mixture. So YA equal to CA by C. And where CA is the concentration of A to the concentration of the mixer, gas mixer. Dalton's law of partial pressure. So let us imagine a container, homogeneous mixture of inert gases at a temperature T, pressure P and volume V. So we take a container, homogeneous mixture of inert gases. They are not the gas constituents, they are not reacting, chemically reacting between them. And the total pressure is P, total volume is V, and total temperature is T. Now we consider there are N1 moles of gas A1 and N2 moles of gas A2. Like that, we have NC moles of gas AC. So we have different gases. N1, N2, N3 are the mole number of moles of the gas A, gas B, gas A1, A2, A3. Like that. Then the mixer is in the state of equilibrium. Then the equilibrium means they are in the chemical equilibrium, they are not reacting with each other. Then the equation of state PV equal to NRU into T. So the perfect gas equation, general perfect gas equation P into V equal to N into RU into T. RU is the universal gas constant. Now the N is the number of moles of the gaseous mixture, so which is equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus up to it is NC. How many gas constituents are available, you can add. So PV equal to N1 plus N2 plus up to NC into RU into T. Now here N1 RU T divided by V, I can rearrange. P equal to N1 into RU T divided by V plus N2 into RU T divided by V up to NC RU T divided by V. So the total volume, total pressure, total temperature, they are constant for the gaseous mixture. And here we call this is partial pressure of the gas 1, N1 RUT divided by V is the partial pressure of gas 1. P2 is N2 RUT divided by V is the partial pressure of gas 2. PC equal to NC RUT divided by V is the partial pressure of gas C. Then P total pressure equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3 up to PC. So this is what the Dalton's law of partial pressure. The total pressure of a mixture of ideal gases is equal to the sum of the partial pressures. This is the Dalton's law of partial pressure, which is very important in all the thermal engineering calculations. Let the gas mixture contains N1 moles of gas A1, N2 moles of gas 2 and NC moles of gas 3. The number of moles, that is what we told. Number of moles equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3 up to NC. Then the mole fraction, X1 equal to N1 by sigma L. So total number of moles divided by the total number of moles, it is also equal to P1 by total pressure. Partial pressure of the gas 1 divided by the total pressure. Similarly, X2 equal to N2 divided by sigma N, R equal to P2 by P1, and XC equal to NC by sigma N, R PC by P. And therefore, you add all these values, X1 plus X2 plus X3 up to XC equal to 1. So, sum of the mole fraction are equal to 1 for the gaseous mixture. And the gas constant for the mixture. So, the RM is the gas constant of the mixture, that is equal to M1 R1 plus M2 R2. Up to MC RC divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. So M1 is the mass of the first gas, R1 is the gas constant of the first gas, M2 is the mass of the second gas, R2 is the gas constant of the second gas. So like that it goes, total mass of the gaseous mixture. So when you have a number of gases in a mixture, this is what the gas constant for the mixture. Then the molecular weight of the mixture, equal to X1 M1. X1 is the mole fraction, M1 is the molecular weight of the first gas, X2 is the mole fraction of the second gas, M2 is the molecular weight of the second gas. So like that, XC, MC. This is the molecular weight of the mixture. And partial volume. So we have different components in a particular gaseous mixture. So different gases. Gas 1, gas 2, gas 3. Then the volume of that component alone would occupy at the pressure and temperature of the mixture. So the total pressure, the pressure and temperature are the same, but what is the volume occupied by a single component? That is what the partial volume, that is given by Amagat's law of partial volume, assert that the volume of a mixture is equal to the sum of the partial volume of its components. So when you have total many gases, so total volume of the gaseous mixture equal to sum of the partial volume, which is V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to VC. Then specific volume of the mixture, so small v equal to capital V divided by M. So capital V is constant divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3 up to MC. So we take 1 by V, that is 1 by specific volume, reverse of reciprocal of this value, one M1 plus M2 up to MC divided by V. So M1 by V1 plus M2 by V2 plus MC by VC, which is 1 by V equal to 1 by V1 plus 1 by V2 up to 1 by VC. So V1, V2, VC is the specific volume of the components. And this final equation, it is what the density of the mixture. So density of the mixture is the sum of the density of individual components. So 1 by rho, 1 by V equal to rho. So rho equal to rho 1 plus rho 2 plus rho 3 up to rho C. So density of the mixture equal to density of each component, sum of the density of each component. And the internal energy of the mixture, Um equal to M1 U1 plus M2 U2 up to MC UC divided by total mass. So M1 is the mass of the first gas, U1 is the internal energy of the first gas, M2 is the mass of the second gas, U2 is the internal energy of the second gas. So like that, divided by the total mass of the gaseous mixture. Similarly, enthalpy of the mixture, HM equal to M1 H1 plus M2 H2 plus up to MC HSC divided by total mass of the mixture. So enthalpy of the mixture, M1 H1 mass of the first gas, H1 enthalpy of the first gas, M2 is the mass of the second gas, H2 is the enthalpy of the second gas. So like that you have to add, divided by the total mass of the mixture. And specific heat of the gaseous mixture, the same fashion we calculate specific heat of the constant volume, M1 CV1 plus M2 CV2 up to MC CVC divided by the total mass of the mixture. CPM, specific heat of the constant pressure of the mixer, m1 cp1 plus m2 cp2 up to mc cpc divided by the total mass of the mixer. Then entropy change due to the diffusion of gas components in the mixer. So the when you have a mixer of different gases, the gas molecules are moving from one place to another place. Because of that, there is change in the entropy. The entropy change is given by SF minus SI equal to minus of m1 r1 logarithmic of p1 by p plus m2 r2 logarithmic of p2 by p up to mc rc logarithmic of pc by p. So p is the total pressure. M1 is the mass of the first gas, R1 is the gas constant of the first gas, P1 is the pressure of the partial pressure of the first gas. Similarly, M2, R2, P2, MC, RC, PC and the other values. And the Helmholtz function, F equal to U minus TS. So Helmholtz function, the difference between internal energy and the product of temperature and entropy of a closed system. So this is a function which is important for the further discussion. And Gibbs function, it is G equal to H minus TS, which is the difference between enthalpy of the enthalpy and the product of temperature and entropy of a steady flow system. So Helmholtz function, the Gibbs function, they are the energy, free energy of the system, free energy of the system. So this is very important for calculating the free energy or available energy of the component. And these are all the reference books I used for preparing the notes. You can also refer to it for additional information. And in the next lecture, we will be solving few problems on the properties of gaseous mixture. And if you have any comments or queries on the topic, you can write to my mail ID. I will answer to your queries. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again.